Dr. Susan Fino joining us live, political science professor at Wayne State University. Dr. Fino, thank you for being with us this morning.
I'm enjoying it.
All right, Dr. Fino, can you tell us what could come of these lawsuits here in Michigan?
Nothing. That's the short answer. There are basically two ways you can contest an election. You can say there were problems in its administration, and you can demand a recount. In order to establish that there are problems with the administration of the election, you have to have admissible evidence for a state court. You would need affidavits of people testifying to irregularities. And I just don't see how that's going to happen. You can have a recount, and most states provide for a recount if a margin is at a certain level, but typically recounts don't change the outcome by more than a few votes one way or another. These lawsuits, as far as I can understand, are just non-starters.
Now, some traditionally Republican-leaning counties in Michigan are turning blue in this election, like Oakland and Kent County. Is the Democratic hold traditionally known in urban areas now moving into the suburbs?
It's not so much the Democratic Party is moving into the suburbs, but the nature of the suburbs' demography is changing. Suburbs are becoming more diverse, they're more minority voters, and of course the vote of women made a big difference in this election. It's almost as if President Trump went out of his way to alienate suburban women. So between the changing demography of counties like Oakland with a larger minority component to them, and with the women's vote, it's not surprising to me that Oakland is getting more Democratic and turned out for Biden in this election.
All right, Dr. Susan Fino from Wayne State University, thank you so much for spending time with us this morning.
You're welcome.
Thank you.